darling. Sorry I'm so late.
That's all right, darling. I'm 20 minutes late myself.
Oh, well, let's not start worrying about that yet.
It's nice here, isn't it?
Oh, yes, it's a very good restaurant. 5 stars, you know.
Oh, really?
Oh, yes. Terrific reputation.
Good evening, madam.
Good evening.
Good evening, sir.
Kira.
Merci, what a pleasure it is to see you here again, sir.
Kira. Apparently the Burfon croûte is fantastic.
If I may recommend, sir, the pheasant à la reine, the sauce is one of the chef's most famous creations.
That sounds very good.
Sounds lovely.
Anyway, darling, have a look at the menu. See what you want, take your time. Oh, by the way, I've got a bit of a dirty fork. Could you get me another one, please? Here.
I beg your pardon?
I've got a bit of a dirty fork. Could you get me another one, please?
Oh, sir, I do apologize.
No need to apologize. Doesn't worry me.
Oh, no. I do apologize, sir. I will fetch the head waiter immediately.
No, please. No need to do that.
Oh, no. I feel sure the head waiter, he will want to apologize to you himself personally. I cannot think how this has happened. I will fetch him at once.
Well, you certainly get good service here, don't you?
Yes, they really look after you here.
Delicious.
Excuse me, sir, madame.
This is filthy. Who the hell washes up? Vis-a-vis, find out who washes up and give them their cars immediately. No, on second thoughts, we can't afford to take any chances. Sack the entire washing up staff.
Look, please, I don't want to cause any trouble.
Oh, no, please, it's quite right that you bring this sort of thing to our attention.
Vis-a-vis, find the manager and tell him what has happened immediately.
Please, I don't want to make any fuss.
Well, no, please, there's no fuss. We simply wish to ensure that nothing interferes with your complete enjoyment of the meal.
Huh. I'm sure it won't. It was only a dirty fork.
I know. And I'm sorry. Bitterly sorry. But I know that nothing I can say can alter the fact that in this restaurant you have been given a dirty, filthy, smelly piece of cutlery.
It wasn't smelly.
It is smelly and obscene and disgusting, and I hate it.
Enough, Gilberto.
Dirty, nasty, smutty.
Gilberto.
Good evening, sir. Good evening, madam. I'm the manager. I've only just heard what's happened. May I sit down?
Yes, of course.
I want to apologize humbly, deeply, and sincerely about the fork.
No, really, it was only a tiny piece of dirt. I mean, you could hardly see it anyway.
Oh, you're good, kind, fine people for saying that. But I can see it. To me, it's like a boulder, a vast bowl of pus.
Oh, it's not that bad.
No, it gets me here. I can't give you any excuses. There are no excuses. I've been meaning to spend more time in the restaurant, but I haven't been too well recently, and things have been going very badly back there. Poor old Mrs. Dalrymple, who prepares the salad, can hardly move her poor swollen fingers. And then, of course, there's Gilberto's war wound. But they're good people, and they're fine people. And together, we were beginning to get over this bad patch. There was light at the end of the tunnel. When this happened!
Can I get you some water?
It's the end of the rope!
You bastards!
You mean us?
You vicious, heartless bastards! Look what you've done to him! He's worked his fingers to the bone to make this place what it is! And you come in here with your petty, vicious, heartless quibbling! And you grind him into the dirt! This fine, honorable man whose boots you are not worthy to kiss! Oh, it makes me mad! Mad! Mad!
Easy, Mongo, easy!
Stop staring.
No, Mongo.
What? No, the wound. They destroyed.
It's the end. The end.
He's dead. They killed him. Revenge.
No, Mongo. Never kill a customer.
Oh, the wound again!
The wound again! The wound again!
Lucky I didn't tell him about the dirty knife.